Cool. Hey, everyone. Welcome back. I got food poisoning yesterday, so didn't really get anything done. But we're back, and we're gonna keep doing more spark stuff because it's the work week, and gotta make money. So what are we doing? Oh yeah, okay. First things first, I want to go look at my Spark PR and the one with stateful sets and also adding the pluggability. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Where did it get left off? Oh, interesting. Okay. Looks like there was a timeout. My guess is that there's probably something in upstream that made things unhappy. Which one failed? Okay, running the hive tests. What failed specifically? Kafka source stress test. Yeah, I give zero shits about that test. Anything with stress test in the name is probably flaky. But you know, oh shit. C'est la vie. Okay. So we'll merge in the master branch, push it. That'll kick off CI. And then we'll sort of see what's happening from there. The other thing that we did was inside of config.yaml. Okay, cool. I think it's over here somewhere. I have so much crap. Okay. Thought I knew where it was. Looks like maybe I don't. Pretty normal for my life. Let's go check out my Docker Hub. Okay. Huh. Last push 2 days ago, but all of the tags are from forever ago. Let's go to tags, newest. Okay, 3121. So that's going to be the new tag that we use. Then. At ease, helm upgrade. Release equals, space equals, helm upgrade. Okay. It's gonna take a hot minute. Let's go ahead and start my server. Here. Oh, interesting. Okay, cool. It looks like the right version. Let's have it run. Pulling the image. Aww. Okay. And then, assuming that this comes up, yeah, okay. Three, one, two, one. Okay, so yeah. Huh. I mean, I sort of get this. Okay. Okay. Oh, interesting. It's probably that it's having to pull. Yeah, it's having to pull the image. That makes sense. And exciting to experiment 625. Cool. That's gonna take a hot minute though, for sure. Okay. Yeah, that's gonna take a while. That's okay. Next thing that we're gonna do, we'll go back to yeah. Okay, so I think what we need to do is we'll start adding some things into the yarn part. Okay, so let's write about the yarn logs. Okay. Similar to kubectl in Kubernetes, yarn offers the yarn kubectl logs. Yarn logs command to look up to get the logs from the command line. Okay. This is a bit different because the yarn logs command is a bit different because it takes ID instead of specific container IDs, although you can restrict it to just specific containers. Although you can restrict it to specific containers. You can restrict it to specific containers. So there is an excellent guide to the yarn logs from All right, let's do this in my, like, weird half. From Hardenworks / Slider. Okay. So, Spark UI is the next piece of magic. Oh, cool, our containers came up. And it looks like they're running, and presumably we computed that sum. Hells yeah. Okay, cool. And so that's actually pretty cool. And I imagine if I press this, that's not gonna work. But you know, solid. Solid. Okay, yeah. No. Okay. Okay. Well, so that's all well and good. Now let's do EX forward first. Okay, cool. So, oh, hey, that's really cool. That you're here from South Korea. Yeah, thanks for dropping in. Okay. Oof. Sorry, that's my leg. Ah, shit. Of course, I immediately knocked my mouse on the ground. Oh, God. Oh, fucking hell. Ah, okay. There we go. Okay. And by phone, I mean mouse. Oh, what was I doing? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. So let's go. I'm going to take a look at Spark PR that I have outgoing, that's pending. Oh, what? What the fuck? Huh? Oh, please re-trigger the workflow. Okay, rerun all jobs. That's fine. Okay. Circling back. Yeah, let's get at our Spark Web UI. TTL forward. Oh, fuck it. Kubectl port forward. Never remember this, but that's all right. Oh, okay. Kubectl port forward. Jupyter dash. Okay. Localhost 4040. Does this give me? Okay, it does. Here's the question: can I access the executors? Because I. Oh. Huh. Map lambda x divided by 0. Cool. So just give me some errors to play around with. Advanced stages. Yeah. Spark UI executor tab. Spark UI standard out standard error executors Kubernetes. Interesting. Worker, I mean, why can I not access the worker web UI? Executors. I see thread dump, but I don't see standard error, standard out. Like, if I go to thread dump. Driver UI. Spark executor UI. Like, it would be nice to have this show up in the Spark Web UI. I'm not entirely sure why it's not. It's not. Maybe I need to enable one of these two PRs. Let's go take a look at them. Okay, I mean, this is fine if I wanted to deploy a separate UI in front of it. But not quite what I want. Spark. Target worker app. Oh, okay, wait, let's go take a look at this. Okay. So, Spark UI reverse proxy. Okay. So I think what we want to do is we want to set this to true as well then. So let's do that in our notebook. restart and run off. Okay. So bounce our kernel. So now we're going to go to localhost 4040 again. It's a little broken. Let's change that to it's really broken. Like, really, really broken? Why is it so broken? Okay. Everything just redirects to jobs. Yeah, this is broken. Okay. Oh no. It'll be fine. I'm just like poking at some shit trying to figure out what the fuck is going on. Okay, are there any docks on this anywhere? Okay, there is. Okay. Enabling running Spark Master as a reverse proxy for worker. In this mode, Spark Master will reverse proxy the worker and application UIs to enable access without requiring direct access to the host. Use with caution as worker and application UIs will not be accessible directly. You will only be able to access them through the master proxy public URL. This URL is for proxy, which is running in front of Spark Master. This is like too ostensibly. Mostly unrelated changes. Which is really inconvenient. Oh, unless no, so oh yeah. Yeah. So, okay. Okay. So hypothetically, yeah, that should not be a text HTML entry. Okay, so I think the main thing that I've learned is that reply to all, pop it out, yeah. No. Gmail's not very smart. Okay, so I tried turning this on. The spark UI. Anyone actively using this feature? In prompt. 3.12. And regardless of what URL. Requested, everything came back as text HTML of the jobs page. Cool. Okay. Well, main thing that we learned here is that functionality does not work just yet. Reverse proxy mode does not yet work. And that's fine. That's kind of how features go. Okay, restart and run all. Okay, the other thing that I wanted to try out was the PolyNote notebook. Let's go to control panel. Yeah, stop server. Yeah. Oh, that's really kind. Thank you. Okay. I want to launch the PolyNote server. I vaguely remember the PolyNote server giving us a better way to access the Spark UI, but I could be wrong. It might not actually. So I just want to try it and see. Cool. Okay, well, it's looking like progress, at least kind of moderate progress. So much crap, no new comments. Okay. Paul, you know, it's gonna take a hot minute to come up. And admittedly, like, I've done a bunch of stuff to the Polynote notebook, so if it doesn't work, it's probably my own damn fault. Log. Okay, interesting. So it pulled the image, started the container notebook, and it says the server is ready. Ah. Interesting. Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, interesting. Okay. Huh. Kind. Okay, it comes in, sets the user, and then it gets fiber failed inside of huboth.scala line 117. Which really that shouldn't. I mean, it's not the biggest surprise in the world. The Polynote install was broken. But you know what? I think. Yeah, we'll skip the Polynote stuff for now then. That's fine. Yarn logs. Oh, yeah. This stuff is super important. Okay. So let's go ahead. SQL datasets. Yeah. Little bit of both. Do to make it sort of work. You know what? Honestly, I'm not kicking it at 100% from yesterday still. When I was a little under the weather. And the Polynote thing being broken, I just don't have the energy to debug my Polynote setup right now. So I think I'm gonna take a break and I'll come back to this the Spark PR in a little bit. See about merging it. I guess, I mean, I could do the Spark UI stuff. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Let's do some of the Spark UI stuff. That'll make me feel good. And we can at least get it to 45 minutes today. Oof, everything hurts. Yeah. Okay. Okay, we're gonna run the 3121 container. Again. What do I do? I think. Yeah, okay. First thing that I'm gonna do here is skewed. Def make skewed if x is greater than 10, return 0 comma x. Okay, and then there we go. Count values by key. Anyways, kernel. Kernel restart and run all. And so here what we're doing is we're making an intentionally skewed data set so that we can okay. Python PySpark PyKey. I guess I could do sort by key. Count by key, there we go. Yeah, so that's like semi-bad. Then we're gonna do more bad, which is gonna be group by key. Oh. Cool. And so now localhost 4040. That's right, we're gonna have to redo our port forwarding. Cool. Let's go into stages. Group by key, count by key. Hmm. These numbers are too small to be useful. Let's go ahead. Cool. Okay. Okay. Also, two executors is maybe not enough to do anything particularly fun. But that's okay. Yeah, let's bump this up to five. Yeah. Let's bump it up to five. And I guess let's take 10 off. Start and run all. Cool. It's going to take a hot minute to come back up. Any executors yet? It's going to probably actually take a hot minute for us to get some executors assigned to us. Okay, two executors up, and we've got another three on the way. So that's a tricky thing. I spark get num exacts. Is that gonna do the trick for me? Nah, it's not there anymore. Yeah, okay. Yeah, also not there anymore. Memory status. See status tracker. Yeah, it's just not there anymore. Oh, it is. Okay, let's go dir. Okay. Get executor infos. That's the part that's not there anymore. Yeah. I know that there's a way internally to wait for the execs to come up, but it's not like particularly clean. Okay. Should we? No. New plan. Skewed. Skewed. Insert cell above. Normal. 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 Okay. There we go. Kernel, we start in the kernel. Because I want to have a nice example that I can give to show the difference between the skewed and. Oh no, fuck. Yeah. Okay. Fifth time's the charm. Okay, cool. Cool. And then we go over here to executors. Cool, we've got some executors. Awesome. I dig it. Yes, okay. Not a lot of storage. That's fine. I guess this is what happens when we run with the defaults. I always forget how slim the defaults are. Ah, oh, it's a bit of a hack. Know there's a better way. Okay, should. Okay, cool. There we go. Looks like it actually ran. So now let's go ahead and refresh. Okay, cool. So Those all succeeded a bit too quickly. Let's add one more zero for good luck. So this count implicitly has a group by key as part of it, and that is the part that is being a little slow. So the right side, you know, this not at all surprising, but I suspect then if we come down here into side. These are all getting the same. Oh yeah, that makes sense because this is the evenly distributed one. Okay. And now we're gonna do terrible, terrible things to this. This is finding your logs, then Spark UI, Spark UI is gone. Okay. I'm going to make this one. This one, this heading is SQL datasets. Okay. It's going to be heading 2, yeah, or heading 1, maybe, yes. Okay. Oh, okay, wait a minute. Heading 3, finding key skew. Spark UI. Cool. Then go back here. This one. Yeah. So those right sides, pretty similar. And we're gonna go here. Yeah. Why is copy to clipboard not doing its normal thing? Let's see. Okay. The Spark UI. Keys Q is one of the big headaches in Spark. Thankfully, the Spark UI lets us see what the shuffle reads are per task, and even allows sorting by shuffle read size. Here we have an evenly distributed RDD and RDD with skew. Unfortunately, this doesn't contain information to tell us what keys are presented, but count by key, similar friends make it easy to figure out our excellent debugging tools once and RDD slash dataset once key skew. Cool. So let's go back here. Is it this one? Not all key skew. That, key skew, yeah, other, admittedly, harder to read signs of key skew. On the stage page. Okay, yeah. I think that's good. Ping. I'm Acknowledgements. Okay, cool. So I think that's good. I think, everything kind of hurts still. I'm still not running at 100% after getting food poisoning yesterday. And so I'm gonna take a break, and I'll come back later on this afternoon. And assuming that the CI passes on this PR, I'll merge it. If it doesn't, I'll dig into that. But I think I'll take this as my cue to take a afternoon break. I don't want to push it too hard while I'm recovering. Let's go find mouse. Cool. So thanks everyone for joining. Especially, thanks to Tikashuk and Gaon. It's great having people chatting. I really appreciate it. It makes my day more fun. Having other people to interact with. So thanks for joining, and I'll see you all around. Probably try and do some writing tonight as well. Don't know if I'll end up streaming that or not tonight. Probably I'll stream it tomorrow. And yeah, the doc will be published eventually. If you want, Shiva. I'm so glad. If you want access to the, work in progress stuff, shoot me an email and I can share the doc with you while we're still working on it. But like, as you can see, it's still like early phase, right? We've got an outline for it, but it's not done. But yeah, Shiva, if you shoot me an email, I'll share the doc with you. So thanks everyone. See y'all around. Oh, cool. And I will share that with you. So I got that. You, I'll click hide so that your email doesn't get shared to the world. I'll see y'all soon. Thanks, y'all. Bye.